Hey guys, Megalithic Maiden JJ Ainsworth here, and I want to talk to you about something really interesting that I found in Egypt. It's almost unbelievable. It is so strange. But I have a tour coming up this November, which is really soon, and we still have spaces if you'd like to join us. Because on our tours, the Megalithmania tour, we'd go to discover. We don't go just to sightsee. But we do go to many amazing places that you can't really miss. But let's get back to what I found in Egypt. I'm going to talk about the Valley of the Kings, and in particular, a certain tomb in the Valley of the Kings. Ramesses VI became the pharaoh after Ramesses V, who was the son of Ramesses VI's older brother, Ramesses IV, ascended the throne. Ramesses VI, in his first 2 years after his coronation, he stopped frequent raids by Libyan or Egyptian marauders in Upper Egypt and buried his predecessor in what is now an unknown tomb of the Theban necropolis. Ramesses VI usurped KV9, a tomb in the Valley of the Kings planned by and for Ramesses V. He had it enlarged and redecorated for himself. The craftsmen's huts near the entrance of KV9 covered up the entrance to Tutankhamun's tomb, saving it from a wave of tomb robberies that occurred within 20 years of Ramesses VI's death. Ramesses VI may have planned and made 6 more tombs in the Valley of the Queens. Egypt lost control of its last strongholds in Canaan around the time of Ramesses VI's reign. Though Egyptian occupation in Nubia continued, the loss of the Asiatic territories strained Egypt's weakening economy and increased prices. With construction projects increasingly hard to find, Ramesses VI usurped the monuments of his forefathers by engraving his cartouches over theirs. Yet he boasted of having covered all the land with great monuments in my name, built in honor of my fathers, the gods. He was fond of cult statues of himself. More are known to betray him than any 20th dynasty king after Ramesses III. Okay, now you know a little bit about Ramesses VI, now it's time to talk about the tomb. This is tomb KV9 in Egypt's Valley of the Kings, and as I said before, it was originally constructed by Pharaoh Ramesses V. He was interred here at one point, but his uncle, Ramesses VI, reused the tomb as his own during the 20th dynasty, which is the period between 1189 BC to 1077 BC. The decorations in the tomb provide the story of the origins of the heavens, earth, the creation of the sun, light, and life itself. The decorative plan for this tomb is one of the most sophisticated in the Valley of the Kings. The walls of the first through third corridors are painted with images from the Book of Gates and the Book of Caverns. The Book of Gates is on the south wall and the Book of Caverns on the north. There are also passages from the Book of Amduat, and in the vestibule there are passages from the Book of the Dead. The walls of the burial chamber, specifically the area behind the broken sarcophagus, is painted with illustrations from the Book of the Earth, while the astronomical ceiling above has decorations from the Book of the Day and the Book of the Night. This tomb holds a bit of a secret, and you have to have an eye for small details to spot it. Do you see it? It's okay if you don't. It's easy to miss. But let's zoom in and see if you can spot it. Can you find it yet? Okay, let's get a bit closer. Hopefully you'll see it. What I think is being portrayed here, it kind of explains itself, really. It looks like contact between some entity or being from outer space and Earth. There's a UFO orb on top of a planet or a celestial body reaching out to Earth, to a being on Earth, to a human. This is unbelievable. The ancient Egyptians wrote down and illustrated contact with beings from the heavens. The fact that this picture exists is astounding, and we need to look further into this. There's just no other thing it really could be portraying except contact. It just tells us what's happening. Another interesting thing, if we look at the orb with arms extended and we compare it to recent UFO sightings with pictures, you will see that they look very similar. It is eerie and uncanny. Our ancient Egyptian ancestors have told us that they had contact with these beings. This is very important for us now and our future. I really must say that I am blown away by the fact that this actually exists. And if you want to check it out, I will do my best on the tour to get inside KV9 in the Valley of the Kings and show you what I saw. I'm sure that you will be blown away as well. Could this be one explanation for why we see all of these misshapen, elongated skulls, not only in Egypt, but around the world? Or even, is it related to the high technology we see in Egypt? Not to mention the pyramids there, but the drill holes and the polygonal walls and just the construction types? What about being related to this flying serpent from the heavens that carries its god? Is all this connected to some beings that we yet don't understand or know about? It's something to really consider. Thank you for watching the video, and please let me know what you think is being portrayed here. In the description box below, I'm going to leave the details of the tour that I will be hosting in Egypt this November 2021. And my name is JJ Ainsworth, also known as Megalithic Maiden, and I'm a writer, tour host, explorer, and symbolist. So I really hope to hear from a lot of you about what you think this is, and hopefully you can visit the area with me and make your own discoveries.